Welcome back to Let's Play Scratches. Director's Cut. Blind, I am Amethyst Lunatari. Leaving the chapel. Oh, those doors slamming behind, I heard that. So I'm assuming now we're gonna talk to Jerry. And let him know what we've found. Just to recap, that disturbing African mask is cursed. It isn't exactly important whether this curse is real or not, even though I'm actually willing to believe that due to my experiences inside that house, but the fact is that Blackwood believed it was real. Very real. What dramatic measures did he take to get rid of it? A murder? A sacrifice? I thought Jerry's coming over here, but... I don't know when that's supposed to be. I don't know what time it is, but I can figure that out. 2 p.m.
Jerry, it's me.
Michael, I was about to call you.
Why?
I've been thinking about what you told me, and you could be onto something there. But I'm worried about your safety now. This could be dangerous.
No, really?
What do you mean by dangerous?
Well, let's suppose you're right, and James Blackwood is indeed hiding somewhere inside the house. He's a madman, a murderer, and your life could be in danger.
Jerry, if James Blackwood is still alive, he'd be nothing more than a harmless, decrepit old man. I don't think I'd have any problem outdoing him.
And what if he is armed?
I'm willing to take that risk. He surely knows I'm here by now. What if he's waiting for me to leave so that he can escape? I can't miss this opportunity.
The opportunity of what, for Christ's sake?
Of knowing. I'm already too much into this, Jerry. And if I don't know what happened inside this house, I won't be able to sleep again.
You're obsessed. You were supposed to finish your book, get some rest, and now look at this. What are you going to say to your editor?
Who knows? Maybe this whole episode inspires me to write that ending. I'm sorry. I can't leave this now, Jerry. It's too late.
I can't believe this. I don't understand you. Doesn't the possibility of spending another night in that house with a creepy old man hiding in the basement scare you?
Yeah. I know what you're trying to do.
It should.
Goodbye, Jerry.
Michael! It's dangerous, do you hear me? Dangerous! You have to leave that place!
I'll keep you informed.
You don't ever do that. We've underestimated the opponent, or possible opponent. I didn't feel like calling Jerry. I don't like this. I don't like where this is going. What are we supposed to do? Go upstairs and look at the mask? What about the electrician? Isn't he still coming? No one said a word about the electrician. Had somebody just been at the front gates? Oh. Molly the electrician again. Missed him again. We're gonna get him tomorrow. Well, this is our last day. That's the same thing, yeah. But there's something else in there. Notice of eviction. Really? On our third day in the place? October 12th, 1976. Well, we have the date that we're here. Well, I know it was already stated. Mr. Michael Arthait. Due to irregularities during its acquisition process carried over by Mr. Jerry P. Carter, you are to immediately leave the property known as Blackwood Manor. If you fail to comply, legal proceedings will be enforced against you. You have 2 days to effectively abandon the property after the issuing of this notice. We take no responsibility for the courier service. A police officer is due to arrive at the Blackwood Manor on Tuesday, October 15th. That's tomorrow. Should you be present, you will be immediately taken into custody without further notification. The National Trust. Huh. So that was the reason why Jerry wanted me to come to the house so badly. I bitterly realized that he wouldn't come for me. It was up to me to find a way to leave the house. That's why he wanted me to leave. Apparently. That's all we know. But we can't leave. The car is not working. No little gifts for us in the... whatever. Glove box. Should we go try to find this mask then? I keep looking to see if I see a figure standing or something. It's the anticipation. Well, there's a dangerous murderer about. The police are coming tomorrow to take me into custody, so let me work on my book. I didn't want to touch the typewriter, nor even to look at it. Let's look for the mask. The mask of doom. Oops. There we go. It had to be my imagination, but the mask seemed to be more menacing than ever. Okay. Call Jerry again, I guess. It's definitely something that, well, he already does know it. Let me guess, I still don't feel like calling Jerry when I get down there. Well, if only there was someone around to give me a jump. And not to jump me, but yeah, give me a jump to get my car started. I didn't want to speak with Jerry after the incident, and I've felt the same way ever since. It was Barbara's day off. Still wondering what we're doing with this stuff here. Maybe something in the garage, but I don't know if it's gonna do any good. Because this thing is a little motor. Some sort of device, yeah. Can we use the dynamo in some way? Oh, I know it's not gonna be this, but, screwdriver. There's so many items now. None of them are useful. I don't even know what this thing, why I have this. What is it again? It's not a dish, it's a lid of a can. Why do we have a can lid? He doesn't even know. Picked up for some reason. I wonder if some of these are just red herrings. Wait, I could have hurt myself. Light it on fire. Oil it. I was trying to dig up her grave. That wasn't useful. Jerry fooled me. I can't believe he did this to me. Faking the acquisition of the house. I have known him for years. I'm deeply hurt, but more so worried. I have a few hours left to do something about Blackwood Manor. If I don't succeed, the solution to the mystery will be lost forever. I can deal with Jerry later. I was fool enough to attempt writing again, but I had to suppress a sudden urge to throw the typewriter through the window. I am not feeling well. Not feeling well. Do we want to go to bed? Are we want to lay down then? So he... Faking the acquisition. Why would he do that? There's some kind of motive for having us come here. But now he wants us to leave. I didn't hear that before. I didn't start this today. That was yesterday. I lit this fire yesterday, didn't I? Well, maybe it was today. Sunday was the rainy day. Monday is the cold day. Yeah, I'm gonna be it. So he says he's not feeling well. Maybe he wants to lay down. I don't know. I was feeling too nervous to try. I was feeling too nervous even to lay down and take a nap. That's what he says. Okay, so I was close in my idea. I had to check a walkthrough. Huh. I can't. It's telling me to get the battery out of this car. Oh no, maybe it's my actual car? I thought I meant this car. I'll just look at it quickly, guys. Maybe I'm in. I tried just to get a hint of what I'm supposed to do. I'm in the car, though. Ah! This car. Not the car in there. It was the uncharged battery of my car. Now we go to the garage. But really, I'd like to drive the other car out of here. That would be cool. But he's too afraid of it. Now I think I want to put this here. We just took it back. Do I have the dynamo now? Wait, it's just making a sound. Screwdriver? I didn't look this far ahead either. I just saw... No, I'm pointing at the battery there. Well, let's... Having the cables connected first is probably a good idea. What cables? I considered doing something about the battery. Now that I had it sitting on the crate, oh, I can't exit out. I was going to get the wires from the car, or this car. So wait. So then the wires must be in this screen somewhere. Wait, maybe not, because it lets us... Are we supposed to get the wires from this car? I didn't look far enough ahead. Because I hate spoiling things for myself like that. Wires. Okay, I'm gonna look at it again and see where we get the wires from. Because I don't think it's anything in my inventory that I could use. Oh, that attaches it. Never mind. That's what that does, that sound. Oh! I can barely see wires running here. They appear and disappear. I could barely see them. Alright. Just happened to not have them attached at that point. Do I have to do it a certain amount of times so we know when we're done? Or is this good? Do one more. Four cranks. It was the battery of my car with supposedly a small charge. I wonder if I could have done that all the way back in the beginning. Like, well, as soon as we got the key to the garage anyway. It was the spot where the car's battery was. Okay, we need to hit that spot then. Oh, here we go. It flashes. Gotcha. Alright. Just want to see if it's anything different. We can't really be leaving. I mean, we still have to unbury the body? Do you have the battery? As I prepared myself to leave the manor, I suddenly felt responsible for disturbing the forces that had up till now lain dormant inside the house. I had to do something. I wanted to leave the place right away, but I couldn't. Not without dealing with the presence haunting the house first. It was my responsibility now. I began debating with myself. But no, what about the future inhabitants? What if they became injured because of what I did? I would have never forgiven myself. I knew it was waiting for me. I had to go. Okay. Just want to see if there was an alternate thing where he does leave. Like a fail state kind of thing. Yeah, I wanna find out how we can dig up this body. It's one thing we didn't do. I didn't notice that before. A shadow. Maybe it's there. Oh! Just damp soil. Evidently, I was in need of a point of reference. I thought about studying that photograph again. We're putting it back. Well, alright, let me look at the photo again. It'll be the third time. Is he gonna realize something that I haven't? Because I would think it would be there. I'm trying to recall where everything is. I have to think he's like one of these paintings has like eyes cut through when he's like hanging out inside one of the walls watching me. He's going through the dining room again. Whatever is he up to? Thank you. Alright, we have to go here and then turn around and go here. Yeah, there's the shadow. I mean, but we have to assume it's the same time of day. The sun shines down here. The shadow is here. There's a little something right there. So whoever's been here all this time hasn't even found out the secrets that I have. They didn't get inside. I mean, for all as we know, they didn't discover the hidden photo. They didn't get inside that special locked drawer in the library. So we're finding more stuff out, and just being here for 3 days, and this person's been hanging out here all this time. Was that the little something I found? So it was next to it, maybe? Oh, he automatically takes the shovel back. I mean, don't take the shovel back. What am I doing? I mean, yeah, take the shovel back. But don't fill in the ground again. Just uncover everything. This way you know where you've been. To it. We have to hit that exact spot. Let's try here. Right next to it. But oh, I have music. I have music. Ah. Yep. I was equally terrified and saddened upon uncovering the dead body of Catherine Blackwood all those years and was left to rot in this improvised tomb. The corpse was all contorted and rotten beyond recognition. What horrified me most was the aspect of its teeth leaping out at disturbing angles. Oh, wait. I tried to pull out a tooth without success. Okay. Our necrodentist here. Oh no, this would be the best. Pliers. Doing my best to contain my repulsion, I pulled a tooth from the body. Poor Mrs. Blackwood. She seemed to be silently shouting at me, or rather crying. I got her tooth. Oh, wait. That's the second time I did that. I meant to hit the magnifying lens and hit this. I'm finally putting the pieces together. I am suffering the same ailment that disturbed Blackwood and in turn Milton. First the whispers, then the feeling of a presence stalking me in the house. The only possible explanation is that the curse is real and I have revived it with my arrival. I must do something about this. I have uncovered the body of Catherine Blackwood, so it was true. They never retrieved it. I wonder if her soul has found some rest. Something tells me it won't. With a lump in my throat, I returned Catherine to her improvised tomb. Not yet, I haven't. It was the tooth that I shamelessly took from the cadaver of Catherine Blackwood. I quietly left, bearing Mrs. Blackwood back to her dead, cold dreams. Well, this thing, this is personal effect. The amulet. I couldn't blend those items together in their current state. What other state can they be put in? That means they can be put together, but in a different state. Are we gonna cook them? Let's see how that would work. So we have a stove up here we haven't used. A small one, but it's in that door. I had to light the stove first. No intention of burning anything. Current state. What is this to do with the tooth? I'll oil the tooth. Are we supposed to cut this up? Alright, I'm gonna have to think on this. Thanks so much for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.